Greetings, YouTube. This is the first video I've done where I've been in my lab downstairs. First time I've been on video. So for those that have been following me, following my project, I'm getting towards the end of doing this conversion on this Bridgeport. The reason I'm doing the video is I'm actually doing a something using the Centroid Acorn and CNC 12 software. They actually have a method of using hotkeys that is open source that Centroid allows the developers to use. There's a couple systems out there. I think it's the Xbox controller. And then there's another one. I can't remember the name of it. Let's see. It's for the VC virtual control panel. But what I'm wanting to do is I'm taking the original controller interface from my my Bridgeport CNC that I'm converting right now. And what I'm going to do is I'm making an adapter board right here. Here's the original keypad. Obviously, it's more than 16 keys, right? But if you look on the back of it, you can see there is a place for a parallel connector. So I'm thinking about right now, I've got, I'm just using a development system I use for other work that I do as a contractor here and there tinkering. But I'm going to develop a board that actually plugs into the back of this controller that will, with USB output using a PIC processor programmed in C code. So when you press these codes, it will automatically do the hotkey for, say, cycle start, stop. I'm going to actually set it up for you. You can jog with it. Where you want to jog in, you know, X, Y, or Z. I'll be able to do a tool length check. I'll be able to do, I think, a few other things. Maybe increase the rapid feed or decrease feed, as well as change the mode from like your slow and fast modes, jog modes. So I'm trying to get all that together. I'm trying to finish this up. Instead of just tossing this hardware that's already there. Sorry about that. So instead of tossing the hardware that's already there, I want to go ahead and re-implement it and use it. And the reason I'm doing the video is, for me, it's no big deal. I'm going to, once I'm done with this platform here, I'm using a Microelectronica C in one of the development boards. I'm going to go ahead and design my own board. Well, when I'm done here in the next couple of weeks, once I've got everything up and running, this board should have, I'm thinking, probably at least 16 to 20 inputs. Probably 16 inputs. Expandable, obviously, but that's where I'm going with this. But if anybody's interested, if you message me, I really don't want to make them for you, but I'll put the pieces together, and if you just, you know, reimburse me for what I got in the parts, you know, you want to solder it together yourself, that's fine. It'll be a small circuit board, and it doesn't necessarily have to be one for that Heidenhain controller, if I'm saying it correctly. I also got another machine that I'm doing, which uses a Fanuc, and I'm going to make it where I can use it. I want to make the board where it's universal for both systems, so it's not just specific to one system, if you will. So that's where I'm going with this. So if anybody's interested in getting one of these boards, so all you got to do is wire it into your system. It'll all of the labels on the circuit board will all be pinned out. So you want to cycle start or jog, you would actually hook the wire for your jog feed in, and probably be, I'll set it up for probably a pull down, where you'll have to set it up for, I'll probably float the pins on the processor and it'll be pulled down, so it'll be like a 10K resistor and, you know, sink in the ground or something like that. So it won't be too hard for you to implement. If it's one of these that I'm being behind me, it'll be almost plug and play with that one. So some of those pins will be actually connected directly into that board for me. But I'll also be able to, if you're not going to plug it up to a board like that with that kind of a connector, you can actually plug directly into the headers on the board. Not a terrible amount of connections going on, other than your 16 connections and your power or your ground. We'll get the 5 volts off the USB, obviously. The hardest part's really just writing the code to make all this happen. I do got it partially working, so I know I can do it. So if anybody's interested, I'm going to post this to YouTube, but if anybody's interest wants one of these, let me know. If I don't get any interest, I'm only going to make my 2 boards. I'm just going to use prototype boards. I'm not going to bother sending them out and getting any. But if anybody's interested and wants one, just let me know and just pay the shipping and whatever. The boards usually, I don't know, the processors are like $5-6 and the boards are, depending on how many I get made at a time, looking about maybe $8-10 a board. So less than $20, get one of these if you want to put it together yourself. Obviously it's going to take a little bit of, you know, a little bit of skill set, but I'll pre-flash the chip for you before it comes and check it. But I want to see the hobby grow. I hate to see this old sheet metal, this old metal rather, recycled on these old Bridgeports. They still have a lot of life left in them. So by adding this functionality to it, hopefully more people will, instead of scrapping them, will say, hey, you know, it's easy, let's do this. And you can't beat the Acorn system, the Centroid system rather. They got some really nice stuff. I was looking at getting into the Ethernet, but the problem with that is, you know, some of their stuff's obviously, I don't want to get into it and make it and publish it. I don't want to violate any of their copyright policies or anything like that, as well as their the USB driver that's on the Acorn board. I was thinking about getting into that one. This works just as good for the most part, and serves the same purpose. So anyways, hit me up in the message. Leave a message here. If you like it, contact, subscribe, share, let your friends know. This won't work on Mach 3. This will only work on the Acorn board. I don't really do anything with Mach 3. There's too much stuff out there, and it, for my needs, it doesn't suit my needs all that well. So this is only going to be for the Acorn board, and it's only going to be specific for the codes that are on the Acorn website for software for that CNC 12. If you have any questions, reach out. Let me know. I'll be documenting this project as it goes through, and I'll be posting videos. I'll try and post once a week as I'm going through this, this design, any problems I might have. But for the most part, I've already seen it run. I know it's going to work. I just got to work out all the bugs now. Thanks again, guys.